Hello students, in the last class we have derived the relation of time response for the case 1, that is undamped case. So now today we will start with a underdamped system wherein zeta lies between 0 and 1. For that, what is the system response in that case? So that we should to derive. So again, consider the second order system with R of s and C of s with the G of s value as omega n square by s square plus 2 zeta omega n s plus omega n square. So this can be written in the equation number 1. So for the underdamped oscillations, zeta lying between 0 and 1. So this one already we have discussed. For unit step input, r of t will be what? 1. Then its corresponding Laplace transform r of s will be 1 by s. Therefore, C of s can be written as R of s into omega n square by s square plus 2 zeta omega n s plus omega n square. Okay, so we know that R of s value is here 1 by s. So therefore, using partial fractions, we can write equation number 2 as C of s is equal to a by s plus b s plus c whole divided by s square plus 2 zeta omega n s plus omega n square, calls as equation number 3. So this is how we need to write using the partial fractions. Now from the equation number 3, we can write omega n square is equal to a into bracket s square plus 2 zeta omega n s plus omega n square plus b s plus c into s, can calls as equation number 4. Now put s equal to 0 in the equation number 4. So what we'll get, we'll look into it. So omega n square is equal to a into bracket 0, because s is here 0, s is here 0, plus omega n square as it is, plus 0 plus c into 0. Therefore, a will become what? Omega n square by omega n square is equal to what? 1. Therefore, a equal to 1. Similarly, to find b and as well as what? C. So, you need to find what method of equating the coefficients. So, therefore, now equate the coefficients of S in the equation number 5 on both ends. Right. So, equation of S, left hand side will be what? 0. Right hand side can write as 2a zeta omega n plus c. Therefore, c is equal to minus 2a zeta omega n. We know the value of a here, substitute here. So we'll get, therefore, c will be what? Minus 2 zeta omega n. Understanding? So therefore, so we are going to write these values. And also we need to find b also. Consider the equation number 4. So omega n square equal to a s square plus 2 zeta omega n s plus a omega n square plus b s square plus c s. Therefore, omega n square is equal to s square a plus b plus s 2a zeta omega n plus c plus a omega n square. Call that equation number as 5. Equate the coefficient of s square on both sides. So we'll get 0 is equal to a plus b. Therefore, b equal to minus c. Therefore, b will be minus. So we got the value of a as well as b as well as what? C also. So substitute these abc value in the equation number 3. We'll get C of s is equal to 1 by s minus s plus 2 zeta omega n whole divided by s square plus 2 zeta omega n s plus omega n square. So you can add and subtract the term zeta square omega n square in the denominator part of the second term. So you will get as 1 by s minus s plus 2 zeta omega n whole divided by s square plus 2 zeta omega n s plus omega square n square, this term aside, and then omega n square minus zeta square omega n square, this term aside. So here to take omega n square common, in bracket you will get 1 minus zeta square. Here you can write this one as s plus zeta omega n whole square. Right. So further we can rewrite this one as splitting the term. Here 2 zeta omega n is there, 1 zeta omega n is here, one more zeta omega n is here. Therefore, C of s is equal to 1 by s minus s plus zeta omega n whole divided by s plus zeta omega n whole square plus omega d square. Well, omega d square is what? Omega n under root 1 minus zeta square, where omega n is a natural frequency, zeta is the damping ratio, omega d is the damping frequency, damping angular frequency. Right. So you can rewrite this term zeta as it is, omega n as omega d under root 1 minus zeta square, that we have written there. Right. So next, again, split up the terms, 1 by s, this term as it is, minus zeta by under root 1 minus zeta square into omega d whole root by s plus zeta omega n whole square plus omega d square, omega square d, right? So taking the inverse Laplace transform, we need to take the inverse Laplace transform for this whole equation. So this can be written as 1 by s inverse Laplace will be 1 minus e raised to minus zeta omega n cos omega dt. You can observe here, inverse Laplace of s plus b, this is of kind s plus b, followed by s plus b square plus a square. So this results in e raised to minus bt cos at. So therefore, e raised to minus zeta omega nt cos omega dt minus this term as it is, minus zeta under root divided by under root 1 minus zeta square as it is. So this will become what? E raised to minus zeta omega nt sin omega dt. So these all both formula holds good only for t greater than 0. Therefore, the end will get what? So c of t equal to 1 minus e raised to minus zeta omega nt. So 1 divided by under root 1 minus zeta square, bracket 1 minus zeta square cos omega dt plus zeta sin d omega dt t. So you can write this one in the form of sin a cos b cos a sin b. So that results in what? Sin a plus b. So this one you can write. So therefore, overall answer will be c of t is equal to 1 minus e raised to minus zeta omega n t whole root by under root 1 minus zeta square sin omega dt plus theta. How to write this one? Theta using damping triangle ratio, so that we can write here, theta is here, adjusting side is what? Zeta. Hypotenuse is what? 1. Opposite will be 1 minus zeta square. From this one we can write tan theta, that will be under root 1 minus zeta square by zeta. Therefore theta will be what? Tan inverse of under root 1 minus zeta square divided by zeta. Right. So therefore, final equation will be what? Sin omega dt plus tan inverse of under root 1 minus zeta square by zeta for this one. Zeta lies between 0 and 1 and t greater than or equal to 0. So final response of a system can be written as c of t versus t with the oscillations. So 1 minus this term will be what? Oscillation part. So that can be represented in the oscillations. Okay, next, case third, so critically damped, wherein zeta is equal to 1. Consider the second order control system. Again, same block diagram with the R of S and C of S, equation also remains same. So in this case, critically damped means zeta value will be what? 1. Again, R of S step input will be what? 1. R of S will be 1 by S. Therefore, C of S can be written as again R of s into omega n square whole divided by 2 omega n s plus omega n square. Here zeta value is what? 1. Right. So therefore c of s is equal to 1 by s omega n square whole divided by s plus omega n whole square. Call that equation as 2. Equation 2 can be rewritten using partial fractions. That is c of s equal to a by s plus b by s plus omega n plus c by s plus omega n whole square. Call that equation as 3. Now rewrite the equation as 4, as omega n square is equal to a into bracket s plus omega n whole square plus b of s into s plus omega n plus c into s. Call that equation as 4. Put s equal to 0, the above equation. So you will get omega n square equal to a bracket 0 plus omega n whole square plus b into 0 plus c into 0. So we'll get a as what? 1. In the above equation, again we put s equal to minus omega n. So we'll get omega n square equal to a into here minus omega n. This results in what? 0. Here also this results in what? 0. Only thing left out term is what? C. So therefore C into minus omega n, therefore C will be what? Omega n, and omega n will cancel, minus omega n will get C. Consider the equation number 4 again here. That we have that omega n square equal to this equation we have. Substitute means simplify this one to get the coefficients of s square and then s as well as constant. Equate the coefficients of s square on both sides of the equation. Here the coefficients of s square are here 0. Coefficients of s square are here a plus b. Here 0. Here 0. Therefore 0 is equal to a plus b. Therefore p equal to minus a. What is the a value here? 1. Therefore b will be what? Minus 1. So now we got a value as 1, b value as minus 1, c value as minus omega. We substitute these a, b, c values in the equation number 3. So we'll get c of s equal to 1 by s minus 1 by s plus omega n minus omega n whole divided by s plus omega n whole square. So now next step is taking the inverse Laplace transform to the above equation. For this equation. So now we'll look into it how exactly that inverse Laplace transform will be taken. C of t will be 1 minus. So answer of inverse of this one will be e raised to minus omega n t. For that we have here inverse Laplace of 1 by s plus a will be e raised to minus a t, which is of the same form. Right. Similarly, inverse Laplace of this one will be minus omega n t e raised to minus omega n t. So this follows this formula. So inverse Laplace of 1 by s plus a whole square is results in what? T e raised to minus a. So therefore, time response represented by graphically for this critically damped case will be, this is the input what we are given in its step. So this is how the time response in the case of critically damped. So rest all the things we'll discuss in the next class. Stop here. Thank you.